Hello everyone, this is tutorial on Docker. In this tutorial, we will discuss about Docker from basic and try to cover each and every concepts which belongs to Docker. So before starting this tutorial, I will request you to please subscribe my channel to get all the notification for my all the upcoming video. So let's start about that. This is my first video related to Docker. So first of all, who is the audience for this tutorial? So the audience of the tutorial is developers, IT professionals, DevOps, and anyone who want to learn and start work with Docker. Okay, so I aim to make a fast-paced and practical guide to get you up and running with Docker. Okay, and if you are interested in Docker, or like a DevOps or container in general, don't worry about that. We will go with one by one. Okay. In this one, we will start with installing Docker and start working with images and containers. Okay. In this one, I will allow you to make familiarize with the image building process, and you will be able to successfully run your program within containers. And I make sure by finishing out this tutorial, you will be able to understand and work with Docker. Fine. So let's start with the introduction of Docker. So at the beginning, Docker was created as an internal tool by a platform as a service that is PaaS company called as Dot. And later in March 2013, it is released as open source. After that, after March 2013, it is available for each and everyone, right? And after that, there are so many companies like Red Hat, IBM, Microsoft, Google, and Cisco Systems, and many more start to contribute toward the Docker and toward to make it more compatible for each and everyone. Okay, so the demands of Docker right now is between the developers or the IT professionals, especially who is working as a DevOps. As you know or don't know about DevOps, DevOps is nothing but the combination of development and operations. So from development it is come as dev, and from operations it is called comes as ops, so it becomes DevOps. Okay, so DevOps, as well as who develop software or anything and want to deploy from development to production issue. Okay, so what is the idea behind to develop Docker? So the basic idea behind Docker is to pack an application with all of its dependencies, okay, and the dependency to make it into a single unit. So what's the single unit? It means all the binary files, libraries, configuration files, scripts, jars, like that, everything should become and comes as a single standardized unit, as which will be easy for development as well as for deployment. So what happened, Docker container, in Docker there is a container, it's called a Docker container, which we will discuss a little bit later. So wrap up all the things which makes to create a creation of any software, like of all the file system, and put into a system that is called an image, which will also a little bit later we'll talk about that. And what happened, that Docker container wrap all the piece of software in a complete file system that contains everything which need to run, like code, runtime, system tools or system libraries, anything which you can install on a server. Okay, so what's the benefit of that? So Docker guarantees that it will always be run in the same way, like no matter what environment it will be deployed in. Okay, so with Docker you can easily build a Java program or Python program or any big data program like that, and it is very easy to deploy and develop. So but we don't have to think about like that Docker is not a programming language or a framework. It is just a tool that helps to solve common problems such as installing, distributing and managing the software. It allows programmers and DevOps to build, ship and run the code anywhere. So after that, we have to understand that what is the difference between virtual machine and Docker container. Okay, so let me discuss first about the traditional virtualization. like that, what are the traditional virtualization we have? So we have right now, and we, everyone will aware about the virtual machine. So what happened that in the virtual machine, we have some, in the case of virtual machine, we have some particular server on which we hosted our OS, and after that on which we put hypervisor, and after that we try to install or create virtual machine 1, virtual machine 2, and virtual machine 3. And inside all virtual machine, we have to install either one particular type of OS, right? In that particular virtual machine, once we open that virtual machine, it will take some memory, some RAM to make it sure that it is running very well. And each and every virtual machine having same type of memory and like particular type of RAM, okay? So suppose my system is like 10 GB of RAM, okay? My host machine having 10 GB of RAM, then hardly we can run 2 or 3 guest OS, okay? Because it will compose and it will utilize each and every RAM to execute it, okay? So by using of all these things, it becomes heavyweight, usually like resource hungry, right? Like they have to take RAM to run the particular virtual machine. So after that, what happened? We can't able to create so many virtual machine on a particular my host machine, okay? I hope this is clear. Now let's jump to the container. What happened, like the Docker software run in an isolated environment that is called as container, like Docker container. So a Docker container is not a virtual machine in a particular sense. It represents operating system virtualization, okay, which will every and each and every virtual machine image run on an independent guest OS. The Docker image run within the same operating system, that is as a kernel. So what happened, once we create like 2 and 3 images, because each in one image we will install MySQL, in second image we can install MySQL, in third image we can install MySQL. So what happened, inside one place we can create multiple time of the same type of application, and it is very useful. We are not going to install, first of all, the boot time will become usually very very fast that compared to virtualization effects, okay? And it is also possible to speed up and roll out of all the conditions, that is suppose we are having 100 of the cases container, so it will be like activated within a second and reduce the time taken provisioning your software. So as you can see, Docker is quite different from like our virtual machine, okay? But we have to understand that both solutions have their own advantage, right? Means virtual machine having their own advantage and Docker container having its own advantage, right? On one hand, we have fully isolated secure virtual machine with average performance, but in the another hand, we have Docker container which are like missing some of the key features, but it is compiled with the high performance that can be provisioned swiftly. Okay, so I hope you can understand about the virtual machine and Docker containerization. Okay, in the next session, we will discuss about what are the benefits of using Dockers, as well as what are the steps we will take to learn and to what are the tools and API we are using inside Docker. So thanks for watching this video. See you into the next session. Till then, please subscribe my channel. Comment down if you are not understanding anything. As well as service. Thanks.